Hi students, today's topic of discussion is series and parallel operation of SCR. SCRs are usually available at ratings up to 10 kilovolt and 3 kilo ampere. But some industrial applications, the demand for voltage and current rating is so high that a single SCR cannot fulfill such requirements. In such cases, SCRs are connected in series in order to meet high voltage demand, and SCRs are connected in parallel to meet high current demand. For series and parallel connected SCRs, it should be ensured that each SCR rating is fully utilized and the system operation is satisfactory. So string efficiency is a term that is used to measuring the degree of utilization of SCRs in a string. Therefore, string efficiency eta S is equal to actual voltage or current rating of whole string divided by individual voltage or current rating of one SCR into number of SCRs in a string. For example, in case of series connected SCRs, string efficiency is equal to actual voltage rating of whole string divided by individual voltage rating of one SCR into number of SCRs in the string. With increase in the number of SCRs in a string, voltage or current handled by each SCR is minimized. This phenomenon increases the reliability of the string but reduces the utilization of each SCR. The measure of reliability of the string is given by a factor called derating factor. So derating factor is equal to 1 minus string efficiency. So derating factor is used to measure the reliability of the string. So now we will discuss the series operation of SCR.
We are analyzing series operation with both static characteristics and dynamic characteristics. First, we will analyze the series operation with static characteristics.
When system voltage or operating voltage is more than the voltage rating of single SCR, SCRs are connected in series in a string. We know that SCRs of same ratings and specifications do not have identical characteristics. Due to this inherent variations in the VI characteristics, the voltage shared by each SCR may not be equal. Means V1 is not equal to V2. Now we can draw the VI characteristics of SCRs T1 and T2. So this one is IA and this one is VA. So we already studied the VI characteristics. So this one is forward breakover voltage VBO1. First I will draw the static VI characteristics of SCR1. So VBO1. So after that it start conducting. So this is the VI characteristics of first SCR. T1. So if you draw the characteristics of second SCR T2, so this is the characteristics of second SCR T2. So this one is VBO2. So this is the characteristics of SCR T2. Suppose this one is I0 is the leakage current through the SCR. For the same leakage current, we can see that voltage across each SCR. So this one is the V2 and this one is V1. So the same leakage current voltage across the each SCR are different. Unequal voltage sharing occur in each SCR. For example, if two SCRs in series that is capable of blocking 5 kilovolt individually, then the string should block 10 kilovolt. 5 plus 5, 10 kilovolt. But practically this does not happen. From the figure we can see that for same leakage current I0, unequal voltage division takes place. So voltage across SCR1 is V1. Say V1 is equal to 5 kilovolt and SCR2 is V2. Suppose V2 is equal to 3 kilovolt. V2 is less than V1. So we can see that first SCR is fully utilized, but the SCR2 is not fully utilized. Hence, the string can block V1 plus V2, that is 8 kilovolt rather than 10 kilovolt. Therefore, the string efficiency eta S is equal to actual voltage rating of the whole string. That is, actual voltage rating of the whole string is V1 plus V2 divided by individual voltage rating of one SCR. That is, we are taking the highest value V1 into number of SCRs in the string. Here, number of SCRs are 2. So, which is equal to V1 plus V2, 8 divided by V1 is 5 into 2, which is equal to 8 by 10. Into 100 means string efficiency is 80% instead of 100%. Here we can see that for the same leakage current, unequal voltage distribution occurs. The main reason behind this unequal voltage distribution is that unequal leakage resistance offered by the SCRs. Because we know that voltage V is equal to I0 into R. So I0 is constant. So voltage variation is because of this resistance variation. So unequal voltage distribution is because of unequal leakage resistance offered by the SCR. Therefore, a uniform voltage distribution in steady state can be achieved by connecting suitable resistance across each SCR. So by connecting a suitable resistance across each SCR, we can achieve equal voltage distribution. So resistances are connected in such a way that each parallel combination, so this one is a parallel combination, this one is a parallel combination, so each parallel combination has the same resistance. So resistance of this parallel combination should be equal to resistance of this parallel combination. This shunt resistance R is called static equalizing resistance. So magnitude of this parallel resistance R can be obtained as, consider n thyristors connected in series. We can divide the entire connection into two parts. First part contains the thyristor T1 and the second part contains n minus 1 SCRs. Here n minus 1 SCRs. Let the SCR T1 has the minimum leakage current IBMN. So current through the SCR1 is IBMN. And the remaining N minus 1 SCRs have the same leakage current of IBMX. So current through all other N minus 1 SCR IBMX. X, IB, M, X, and also IB, M, X is greater than IB, M, N. So from the figure, it is clear that SCR with the lower leakage current blocks more voltage. So here SCR1 has lower leakage current IBMN, it will block the voltage VBM. VBM is the maximum permissible blocking voltage of SCR1, which is more than the voltage shared by each of the other N minus 1 SCRs. And VS is the total voltage across whole string. I1 is the current flowing through the equalizing resistor of first SCR, and I2 is the current flowing through equalizing resistance of all other SCRs. I is the total string current. Consider this portion, we can write, that is using Kirchoff current law, we can write I is equal to I1 plus IBMN. Therefore, I1 is equal to I minus IBMN. Similarly, consider this junction. I is equal to I2 plus IBMX. Therefore, I2 is equal to I minus IBMX. Also, the voltage VBM. So the VBM is the voltage across the SCR T1. So the voltage VBM is equal to I1 into R. I1 into equalizing resistance R. Using the circuit, we can write the string voltage. The string voltage VS is equal to this voltage, because we are divide the whole circuit into two parts. So voltage of the voltage across the SCR 1 plus voltage across N minus 1 SCRs. So voltage across the SCR 1 is I1 into R. I1 into R plus voltage across N minus 1 SCR, we can write as N minus 1 into I2 into R. So which is equal to I1 into R plus N minus 1 into, instead of I2, we can write I minus IBMX. I minus IBMX into R. So which is equal to I1 into R plus N minus 1 into, instead of this I, we can write I1 plus IBMN. I1 plus IBMN minus IBMX into R. So which is equal to I1 into R plus N minus 1 into I1 minus of IB M X minus IB M N into R. So which is equal to I1 into R plus N minus 1 into I1 minus IB MX minus IB MN. We can write as delta IB into R, which is equal to, also we can see that I1 into R, this I1 into R is equal to VBM. So instead of I1 into R, we can write VBM plus N minus 1 into I1 R minus delta IB into R, which is equal to VBM plus N minus 1 into I1 into R minus N minus 1 into delta IB into R. Here also, instead of I1 into R, we can write VBM. So, which is equal to VBM plus N minus 1 into VBM minus N minus 1 into delta IB into R. So, which is equal to, we can take VBM as common. So, 1 plus N minus 1 minus N minus 1 into delta IB into R. 1 cancelled. This one is Vs. Vs is equal to, from this equation we can write the value of equalizing resistance R is equal to N into VBM minus Vs divided by N minus 1 into delta IB. Using this equation, we can obtain the value of equalizing resistance. So, this resistance is known as static equalizing resistance, RS. So, this one is the RS.
Thank you.